Meet Mateo Mateus, one of the most famous football players in the world. He's had all the success that you could possibly achieve.
Many people know Mateo Mateus is one of the greatest football players in the world today. But did you know that his story to greatness was flawed with difficulties? Growing up in extreme poverty made it really difficult for him to make it to the big league.
So Mateus, how did you survive growing up before football?
From a young age, I was working 10-hour shifts, picking up the rubbish on the side of the road where people would just leave it. And then, got minimal pay, maybe like $1 an hour. Yeah, it was tough working to pay for the family, everyone to contribute. Yeah.
Coming from a poor background, the only thing Matt had going for him was the game of soccer. Due to his high skills, he became a bit of a local hero.
I see, Matthias.
Well, obviously I've known the boy from Norwich. I remember it was his second birthday, I saved up for quite a bit. Went to a charity shop, bought him some new soccer boots. Ever since, you know, on the pitch every day, he loves them. 10-hour days, yeah, he's a superstar.
Estou tão sozinho. Porque tudo é tão triste. Beleza que existe. Beleza que não é só minha, que também passa sozinha.
Despite Matt's insane skills, life was still tough. Him and his family worked hard to survive.
No luck. I just worked 12-hour days, 10 cents an hour. I can't afford to put food on the table, let alone buy soccer boots for Matt. I just, you know, he's got the ability to make a pro, but it's just, we can't do it, you know? Like, it's Yeah.
You know, back then, times are tough, so I just had to work hard, grind, and just at it every day until I got there.
Matt clearly had the skills to make it pro, but would he ever make it? We'll just have to wait and see.
So what do you think is the effect or influence of money in sport?
Oh, I don't know. I've never really thought about it.
All right, so this is why the football system doesn't work in Australia. The first competitive level we have is NPL. The average cost to join that is around $2,000, plus your $200 for boots to play, and plus another $400 for your kits. That equals $2,600 a year. Most people can't even afford that. If you want to go even further, you might get selected for the state. But if you get selected, you have to pay for your own flights. That's at least $1,000 per person. Plus $600 for your kit and everything. At least a week of accommodation. And that will go to min $2,200. It can range a lot more than that, up to $3,500. If you want to go international, you have to pay for your own living costs and you don't have any connections. This makes it extremely hard for footballers wanting to become professional overseas, especially from Australia.
Extreme star costs create difficulties for good potential world-class players to get recognised. Ronaldo, Rooney, Ronaldinho, Mateo Mateus, all players with world-class potential, but none of them would have made it in Australia as they just don't come from wealthy backgrounds. Football should be a sport where the best players in the world get in, not the ones with the most privileges.
The Australian Soccer League is a direct example of how greed and money can influence someone's ability to become prosperous in the sport of soccer. It's a direct example of how money has a direct influence in sport and shows that even the most skilled players can't make it pro if they don't have enough money.
In contrast to the local scene, when major funding is lacking, on the international scale, money is abused by clubs to gain power in football.
An example of how money influences sport on the international level is the Saudi League. The Saudi League has very wealthy club owners, which are able to buy players for large sums of money, which has created a competitive league that didn't exist before money was spent in that league.
An example of this in the Saudi League was in the past few years, they spent over $1 billion USD to transform the league from a less recognised league to a league full of star players. Players included in this was Ronaldo, who got offered $200 million USD yearly. And another example would be Mbappe, who didn't take the offer, but was offered $332 million USD yearly.
So Zidane, when did you first see Matheus?
You know, I'll never forget that day. I was walking home, walking my dog. On the side of the street, I see this guy, KP-ups, kicking it 50 meters in the air, taking a touch, clean as. From that day on, I knew that kid had talent, and I just followed him everywhere he went.
Hey!
What's your name, son? Matheus. You got a lot of talent, mate. How'd you like to play for the big leagues? I would love to.
Without Zidane, I just don't think I would have made it, you know? Like, I knew I was good enough, but I just didn't have a pathway, I didn't have the money, I didn't have the funds to get there, you know?
In Mateo's case, money was used positively to change his life. However, in other cases, money can be a negative impact on sport and doesn't go to those who deserve it.
Yeah, I'm Lord Hume. You know, I'm easily the best in the team. Dad's a treasurer. Just, yeah, I hardly go to training. I just rock up. I'm just the best, you know how it is.
While Matt was working hard in poverty, players like Lord Hume, who come from wealthy backgrounds and have club connections, are given free opportunities to make it big.
It just is insane.
But due to the fact Matt worked harder than everyone in the club, it wouldn't be long till he made his first club debut.
My first game, I remember every second of it. I was so pumped. I was excited. I wanted to get there and I just wanted to play.
Matheus picking up pace midfield. Oh, well played again.
Tensions built while Matt went up to shoot for his penalty. Everything relied on this shot.
Matheus' shot. That's fantastic. That's one of the best individual goals we're going to see in the World Cup, surely.
Matt's first game went down as a huge success. This success continued throughout his career, becoming one of the most popular players in the whole world.